Hey everybody, it's Kevin Tumman. I'm going to show you how to send files and folders to anywhere in the world with no limits for free and stuff. So first we're going to open DaVinci Resolve. Nah, just kidding. This tutorial is actually an easy way to be able to send large files, folders, zip files, whatever it may be, and an unlimited amount of file size anywhere in the world, completely for free without needing to sign up for any sort of account. It just goes from one place to another directly. And we can do this with a very simple software called Croc. And this is available for PC, Mac, Linux, whatever you use. Now I do just want to point out really quick that it is a command line utility, but we're going to go over things step by step, and it's really easy to use, even if you've never opened up a command prompt in your life. Now I'm going to show you how to install it for both Windows and Mac, because it is different on how you install it both ways. So the first one will be for Windows, and then if you're on a Mac, you can skip ahead to that timestamp. Or if you're on a PC, you can watch this part and then skip the Mac part later because you don't have one. And I will mention that there are mobile versions of this as well. There is a free one for Android, and there is a paid one for iOS. It's $5. Now, there are free alternatives for iPhone like Zender, Local Send, Magic Wormhole, but we're not going to get into the mobile versions today. That can be for another video potentially. So to install Croc on Windows, it's very simple. We just go to the GitHub page, and then we scroll down until we see this install tab. And then we just copy this code right here, specifically for Windows. So we can copy this code, and then we can open up a command prompt by pressing the Windows key and typing in CMD. We type that in, and then we just paste that code in, and then it'll load the Croc installer, and it'll download accordingly. It'll also ask you for your admin password, so we'll just go ahead and enter that. And it won't show the password when you enter it, so just make sure you're doing it correctly. It is case sensitive. It's the same way on a Mac as well. We're going ahead, press enter, and it'll install it. Now on a Mac, there's an extra first thing we have to do, which is download a package manager called Homebrew. A package manager is basically something that downloads, installs, and puts files in the right places so that the program can run correctly. It's basically what the App Store does, but for apps without an App Store. So to install it on a Mac, we just need to go to brew.sh, and it'll have this copy icon right here. And hitting that will copy this command line that we need to run to install Homebrew. And then go up to your magnifying glass and type in terminal. And then we can command V paste that code into the terminal, press return. It's going to ask us for our admin password. So go ahead and enter that. And then press return, and then press return again. And now it'll run through the installation. Once that's done, we can tell Homebrew we want to install Croc by typing in brew install Croc. And that will add Croc to your system, and now you can actually use it. So now that you have it installed on whichever operating system you're using, we're going to go ahead and actually use the software. It's actually very simple. On Windows, you can just open your command prompt or PowerShell, and on Mac, you can just open your terminal. And all we have to do with that is if I open command prompt here, I just make sure I have the folder open of the files or folders that I want to send. And then all I have to type inside of the command prompt first is I just type in croc, because that means we're opening the application. And then I just type in send, because we're telling it we're going to send some files. So I can drag in a single file here and just drag and drop. And then I just press enter. And then it'll hash it, which basically means it's converting into a set length of data that it can make sure it sends securely. And then once it's done with the hashing process, it'll show our codes that we can use. Now, here's the discrepancy that I just want to point out really quick. On Windows machines, if you're receiving files, this is the code that you're going to use. If you're on Linux or Mac, you'll want to copy this one. They're effectively going to do the same thing. There's just an extra little thing that's needed for security purposes for Linux and Mac. But once you have this code, you can send it to whoever needs to receive those files and or folders. Now, make sure they have Croc installed on their system, because if they don't, they can't do anything with the code. It's completely useless to them. So the recipient should also make sure they have the folder open where they want all those files to go. And in order to do that, we need to open command prompt in that exact folder or terminal in a Mac, which I'll show in a minute. Because if you open command prompt normally, it defaults to your home or username address, which you can also change from the shortcut properties, but that's not important for this video. Now on Windows 10 or 11, you do this by clicking the file path up at the top right here of File Explorer and ensuring it's fully highlighted. you can just type in CMD and then press enter. And this will open command prompt in the folder that you currently have open. Once the command prompt is open, type croc followed by the code. You can type that in or paste it, however you send it to them, and press enter. And then croc will look for that code and see if there's any files being sent. And if this is your first time using croc, you might have to allow access like you do here. Once croc finds the file or files, it'll ask you if you want to accept those files. Just type in Y for yes and then press enter. And then croc will send that file into that folder that you have open. Once the transfer is complete, you'll see a confirmation that the file was sent successfully. And then you'll see the file inside of our folder right here. And now let's just show it on the Mac, for instance. Let's just send two files here just for a fun example here. Actually, let's do three because I'm feeling sporty today. So I'm going to go ahead and do this again, croc send, and then I'm just going to drag all three files into here, and it's going to put all three files inside of our command prompt. So I press enter, it's going to send three files. So now I just have to go over to the Mac side. And then on a Mac, in order to open the folder that you have open, we're just going to go down to the path that we see here and then right click on the folder and then select open in terminal. And that'll open terminal in the exact folder that we're in. So now we can paste our code and then press enter or return. It's going to do the same thing. I'm going to hit yes. And we're going to receive all three files. And now the files have ended up on the Mac. And then a couple more things to point out is sometimes you might experience an interruption, and sometimes it might even recognize that. So if you try to send the same file again, it'll ask if you want to resume that same file, and then you don't have to start over from the beginning if a file got interrupted. Which also brings me to the next point I want to bring up, which is that it's very highly recommended that you do these types of file transfers over Ethernet and not Wi-Fi if possible, because Wi-Fi is a lot more unstable and any interruption could cut off the connection. And the next point I want to bring up is if you drag and drop a folder in and then for some reason it doesn't want to send it and it gives you some sort of an error saying that it can't find the file path or something similar to that, then a good rule of thumb is to make your folder name short, or you can try and zip the file too. And a way you can zip the file, and I'm just going to go ahead and do an example here. Let's just say I was sending this whole folder here. I can do croc send, and just like before, we can just drag and drop this entire folder and it'll hash everything inside. It wants to send 10 files and the folder. You do that stuff. Or what you can do instead, I'm going to cancel out, is you can actually right click and hit compress to zip file. And that'll make a zip of everything, and you can drag and drop that as well. And just to test that, we're going to do croc send, click and drag that zip, and it'll just say we're sending just the zip file and everything will be inside of it. This also might be a good way to send files in general, just because a zip file will tend to be slightly smaller than everything that you're trying to send at once. And then really quick on a Mac, the way to do that is very simple. You can just highlight all the files and or folders that you're zipping, right click, and then hit compress. Now hopefully this tutorial is really helpful for you. If you want to learn more about croc, I strongly suggest you checking out the GitHub page where you can learn how to set proxies, send more than just files and folders, or exclude folders if you're trying to send a large group of things but you want to make sure that some things don't get sent. All that can be found on the GitHub page. Check it out. It's really cool. And support the developers because they deserve to be supported because they're cool. Now if you have any more questions, please leave a comment down below. And if you post an alligator down there, you're fired. And don't forget to follow me on Twitch where I do live streams of Resolve edits as well. And this is Camera Tim, signing out. I guess a folder is known as a crockpot.